Aha! No! No, 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 no. We got a little bit more there. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Hello, Dogsy. Welcome back to another edition of Sky Lords Agrarian Skies. Hi, stay. Thank you. Thank you very much. No, all the passive mobs attack you, except for the dogs. They are tameable and they protect thee. Do you want the burger, boy? Do you want a burger? I'll throw a burger in your face. How's everybody? Oh, there's another one right there. How's everybody doing today? I hope that you're having yourself a very fantastic day. Can you please get out of the pit? I'm going to place... Ah, dang it. Hope everybody's having a fantastic day. I am very brand new at Minecraft today. No, I ain't not. I ain't not. I haven't been playing Minecraft, or I haven't been recording in quite a bit, or in quite a while, actually, because I've been sick. I was telling you in the last episode that I was feeling very, very down, and that was the truth after the video was recorded, which luckily it was backlogged a little bit, so it didn't cause a hiccup in the series, I don't think. Can I put you back? Thank you. We just made it. Didn't cause a hiccup in the series, at least, which is good, but I've been super freaking sick. Why do I keep looking at the camera? So here's the thing, I've been streaming since the last episode with a face cam and everything. It was absolutely amazing. I'm sorry if you missed it. I had a lot of fun with a lot of you wonderful, awesome people. That was very, very interesting indeed. As you can see, by the way, hey, what is this? There's a new island here. Oh yes, baby, I have been playing Minecraft, but I haven't been able to record. And it's kind of been a good thing for me, I suppose, because I've been able to put up this second island, which I think, unfortunately, I made a little bit too big. But that's fine. We're going to build a bridge here today. That's something that I'm very excited about. But first, I want to show you, hey, chicken... These are so crazy. Look at the dog. He's just ready to eat bird. My dog in real life, she is terrible. You know those small, super cute birds? She kills them. She jumps up and she grabs them and kills them. It's terrible. But check this beauty out. The wind... Hmil. Still a little bit... No, dog. Don't you jump. Sit. Thank you. They're crazy. I've had quite a few that have jumped down. still a little bit too close to the background here, unfortunately. We will change out the white wool for something else. But last time we built this windmill and there were a screenshot sent in by Anna. Thank you so much, Anna. Thank you for all your support over the months you've been with me for such a long time now. I really appreciate it. The average length of a viewer, I know that a lot of you guys here on the channel watch me and keep watching, which I really enjoy and really appreciate. Thank you very much. But the average length of a viewer is somewhere around maybe 1 month and then they get bored and they move on. But Anna, you've been here longer than that, so thank you so very much for your support. And this was an amazing windmill that you sent me a screenshot of. Guys, if you haven't seen it, she did a bit better job than I did, for sure. But go check out her screenshot. It is a beautiful, beautiful thing. And I just pretty much copied it as best as I could. And I think it's gorgeous. I'm going to call this windmill the Windmill Anna. Mm-hmm. That's how it's going to be. All right, anyway... Where were I? We're going to build a bridge today. That's what we're going to do. I want to go and have a look-see over here. Thank you guys so much for the likes and the comments on the last video, if I didn't say so. You guys were really happy to see the windmill, and you said that everything was coming along just fine. And I didn't get a single comment saying that, hey, you should do quests. Oh, this is a quest pack. You should do quests, because that's usually what happens. But you know what? I don't care. Look at me caring. I'm going to go to bed. No, I just want to build. I just want to have some fun, okay? I didn't get a single comment, so I shouldn't complain. I've even put my bed down here. And also, a very important thing that happened in the last episode was that we took a look at the custom NPC gorgeousness. All the decorative items, all the barrels... all of these signs and lamps, and I kind of wasn't sure how that was gonna sit with you all. So I didn't want to do anything until I saw your comments, but then I saw that everybody was for. Everybody said, yes, do make use of the beautiful custom NPC stuff. So what I did was that I created traders, and I tried to figure out what would be in the recipes, and I think I got it pretty fair. So for example, dark oak, I could buy a shelf, boom, and it's gonna snag 3 dark oak from me. So you see the price to the left and the item to the right. And I don't think that is shitty at all, actually. I think that is fair. And since you guys agreed, that's cool. Added a few of these things. Lamps for sure. That's going to be a glowstone and 4 stones. This book thing. tombstone. Oh, I was planning we put a graveyard in this place somewhere for sure. I want to copy what Rendog, my good friend Rendog, does in his single player series, which I think is fantastic. Every time he dies, he has to put up a grave, and I want to do that. And I've died 4 times, which is a good start for a graveyard. But let's get started, shall we? I'm just talking. Let's get started building a bridge. You know, it's kind of weird. All right, what did you want, Meepig? Yeah, they come, they attack, and then they're like, I didn't do it. I didn't do it, and they flee. Yeah, what's kind of weird for someone that records videos and puts them up on the YouTube is the timing of the video. I think I had like 4 days after recording last episode and posting it. And so you have to kind of wait for the, or I want to wait for the feedback, because that's kind of why I put stuff up on the YouTubes. But it feels like I haven't been playing here in a long time with you guys, while for you, I can imagine that it's kind of like, oh, we did this yesterday, whenever this video goes out, you know? Let's see, I saw a very, very good, I want to do a hang bridge. This is why I've done kind of like a stony foundation thing here. I saw a really cool screenshot, can't remember what it was for, but they had, I think it was like Hypixel or Mineplex, and it was a really easy design of a hanging bridge that actually looked, it didn't look overcomplicated, which is maybe why I selected it, but it looked fantastic, it looked really good. So I'm gonna just see if I can copy how that was. I think it was one of these, you know, map making things. So I wanted to speak to you guys about a thing that I experienced last weekend, which is, by the time of the recording, just 2 days ago. Hopefully this video goes out on tomorrow, my time. But anyway, last weekend, doesn't really matter when it happened, because you will never know. You will never know. You don't have to know. But we were having a bachelor party, me and a lot of friends of mine, for my very best friend, for my you know, childhood friend that I grew up with, that I've spent so much time with in the past. He's getting married. Can you believe it? We're in the age now where it's kind of just me and in the group of people that aren't married or haven't even started thinking about marriage and those kind of things. But yeah, he's getting married, pretty insane. So I arranged a bachelor party for him, which was very, very interesting. I'm not much for parties. That sounds sad, or that sounds like I'm very boring, but no, not at all. I don't think, at least. We're gonna make this a 2 wide bridge, by the way, which is kind of interesting. I always go with uneven numbers, just saying. Was this how it was that I saw it? Yeah, I think so. anyway, we're gonna need a crafting table here. Yeah, we're having a bachelor party for this guy, and I arranged it, and we went out on this floating boat, which isn't really a floating boat. What are they called? Like a, I don't know the English word. You know, yeah, a raft. A raft? Is that a thing? I think these went here, actually. Yeah. A raft. We went out on a raft that had a sauna on it, and then some music and stuff. I'm not much for partying, but I like, those of you who know me knows that I like my beers, and I like hanging out with people. I'm just not much for getting super drunk and kind of forgetting what happened that day, because I think it's kind of like wasteful. And I don't know, maybe that's weird, maybe not. You can think whatever you want, but I do enjoy the social part of any party, meeting with friends and that whole part. And so we went out on this boat. Should we? I didn't think this through. But look at how gorgeous this is. already. Like, it's yeah, it's not very pretty yet, but it will become pretty. You just wait, okay? You gotta trust me. I know you do. But let's make a little bit of a staircase here, shall we? Because this was totally the wrong height. Hello, slime. So yeah, the boat went out there, had sauna, drank some beers. Are you not my friend yet, buddy? I don't think so. I don't see a color on this guy. No. Okay. We had some beers, we listened to music, we ate burgers because I arranged it, so I got to select the food that they had to cater in and things. And of course, you know, why not burgers? Because it's like the best food ever. Can't argue with that kind of thing. And it was a really good time. It was a really good time. Then some of the guys came up with a brilliant idea that, hey, that's after the boat trip. Let's go to a, because it's a whole day event, by the way, this bachelor party. And we had booked dinner in the evening, but they wanted to, there was a bit of spare time, so they wanted us to go to a forest and shoot each other with airsoft guns, soft air guns, things like toy weapons, but with bullets of plastic that really freaking hurt, okay? It really freaking hurt. My back looks so messed up after that shootout, but I kind of enjoyed it. So that was a fun day. Then we went out for dinner and we had, I had a burger for the evening because, yeah, why would you not have burgers again? It's the best food ever. And my friend, we had brunch today where we went out and had a little bit of breakfast together, me and him and his wife-to-be and my girlfriend. And it was fantastic. And he said that, you know, he was very grateful. He was like, thank you so much for the party. It was so much fun. I had an amazing time. And yes, I wanted to share that moment. I thought it was a great time with some raft floating on the water. We bathed as well. We went water skiing. I didn't water ski though because I was sick. That was the whole sad thing with the thing that I unfortunately was very sick. And I guess it didn't really help the whole sickness situation that you take a swim in very cold water in Sweden in the pouring rain. But you know, it was very fun. And you can't skip out on a bachelor party for your best friend. That's just how it goes. Okay, so this ain't very impressive, but what I saw in the screenshot, and this was actually a pretty nifty tactics, was that they brought down. Yeah, they used fences, kind of like. I suppose it wouldn't make sense that we have that there. So let's change that out for this, maybe. They used fences as the structural things underneath it, which I got really inspired by. I thought it looked so pretty, so I wanted to try it. Yeah, that looks good already, I think. And then they had it like randomly, I guess. I think it was dropped down like that even. Yes, it was at places. Not sure what these middle parts are supposed to represent, but it's pretty. It looks good, I think. And so I'm gonna do it. And hopefully you guys agree with me that it looks kind of pretty, that it looks kind of gorgeous. It's so weird that I keep looking up to my webcam. I'm almost getting scared by myself. People have asked, by the way, for me to do face cam wow, sorry. Thank you so much for everybody that turned up in the screen in the stream. Will I do it again? Maybe. Maybe, baby. I had a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. However, it was very different as well from doing your YouTube video where you can focus a lot on the production of the video. And so it's something that I need to practice, I think. But people seem to enjoy it. Go down in the comments for those of you who were there and give me more encouragement, please, if you want to. People seem to enjoy it anyway. I think this is how it went. Yeah. I think this looks pretty good. It's very plain, but it's kind of cool as well. Look at that. It's time to bring you in, everybody. I've been doing small things here and there, like planting mushrooms and doing trees, but I really think this island, apart from this little sheep pen, is coming together. It's coming together. Yes, it's definitely pretty gorgeous. And I wanted to show you the gorgeousness during the nighttime. What do you think about this? I kind of used the trees to hang these lanterns. You see, the problem is that they don't really connect to anything. So they are anything that's as small as they are. And so I think this is a pretty good... good idea to have them hanging from thing. This we did the last episode, but you see over there. pretty good looking, I think. And look at those beautiful skies. It's pretty good looking. If we take a looky from over here. Oh, yes. That's the feeling that I want to have, baby. That's the feeling that I want to have. We may want to plant a tree over there. I did light up the little lake we did. There was a very cool suggestion, which I don't think I want to do today, but that I want to explore further down the line, that said, make a secret entrance to something through the lake, someone said. And yes, that sounds good. That sounds great. Take a look at the bridge as well, and then I'm going to show you a problem that we have, okay? I added these lights. These are glowstone illuminators with some... micro parts around them. Think that looks pretty cool. I added a beam in the middle and then leaves. When in doubt, add leaves. I actually mixed in some jungle as well because I thought it was a little bit too plain, but I think it's actually very good. It's much better than the great wood to have the bridge like this for sure. And oh wow, that's the first time I see the lights in the dark. But I'm going to take a freebie now. I want to talk to you guys about something that is a little bit of a dilemma that I may have a solution to. We're going to try something. we go up here. You see, when I found this area, I was very, very important on, or it was very important to me, that it was a forest or a jungle or a plains biome. And I thought everything was a forest biome, but check this out. Holy cow, that's a lot of cows, speaking about cows. But check this out, it's a freaking taiga. Look at that, it's like covering up the entire island here. So I don't like that, I don't like that at all. I don't like the feeling of the grass color or anything like that. So I think what we will do is instead of having that island as our Tormcraft island, let's leave it kind of flat and let's try and build a farm. And I got the inspiration from all the stupid cows and animals over there that have spawned. Let's try and make like a big wheat field where the taiga is and other crops so that isn't visible. I think that could be a pretty good idea. I need to go grab a lot of stuff to do that though. But basically, I'm thinking, just to give you a little bit of an outline, I don't want to mess with these guys. They're going to wreck me. But I'm thinking we build like some kind of farm... house, steampunk, of course, because that is the style. Hello, guys. You want to come to the party? Yeah, I'm going to slay you. You ain't got nothing. Anyone else want something? I don't like this mod, actually. I think it's pretty terrible. I was really hoping that it was only an alpha thing, that the cows and such are hostile. I suppose that it's... look at this. I suppose that it's kind of adding to the whole challenge if you're doing this solely quest-wise and if you don't, you know, do any specific base and you can just lock them down. Sure, but I don't like it anyway. Let's just map this out. So if we have a building, a rather large building that kind of stocks the wheat and all the crops, a crop building, we can make it... Oh, yes, I get an idea now. Did I have any hay bales? No, I have them somewhere. I've made hay bales. We make a farmy steampunk house that is cobblestone or stone foundation, just like these buildings are, but we make it larger, much larger, and not as tall, so we make it pretty flat. And so the footprint for this bad boy could be something like this. I hope that you can imagine what I'm trying to, what I'm trying to sell to you here. And then, I'm losing my voice, flu isn't over quite yet. Yes, and then we have it open here, open in the bottom, and like a staircase up to the thing. Kind of like the lumber mill I did in my vanilla series a long time ago, only that we put a steampunk roof on it, and maybe one of these extensions. That is gorgeous, by the way, right there. So I put that up there, and then over here, I just take all of this grass and I try and crop it into crop things. We also have to figure out where the road could be for the next island. So if we go over here, there's going to be taiga for quite a while. And I don't think I want to go taiga, really, to be honest with you. I don't really like this grass color. It's good for castly builds. But I kind of want to go with this green. So over here, we definitely have forest hills and plains. That's good. That's okay. It's decent. There's taiga over here, though. Crap. Yeah, maybe the next island will come like here. So then, what about... And I'm just bringing you in on the process now. Just bringing you in on the process. What about marking down the... Actually, that's a little bit too close for my taste. Over here, maybe, could be the next bridge. And one thing that I want to do as well is build... I want to utilize the underneath of the Sky Islands in the future. So I want to make sure that we don't... forget about the underneath, because I think that nether portal just by itself is looking pretty gorgeous down there. But yes, this could be the bridge to the next island. So I'm gonna leave the footprint kind of where it is. I could move the footprint over a little bit this way. We'll see how far I get here, though. Holy cow, that's a lot of wolves. You know what? I'm gonna tame all of them if I can. We have like a wolf army. Go, wolf army! See, I'm being... these aren't on my side yet. Alright, I go put down the crops. I'll do all that off camera because I need to collect some stuff. Plus, my girlfriend needs to have a meeting in real life, so I can't record for the next hour. So it would be a good time for me to just plant down some crops. I hope that you guys will be fine with me doing that off camera. Anyway, I do that now and then I come back to you. This wheat growing business is hard, I tell you. It takes time when you use AgriCraft. I just stepped back, took a look-see at what I had done, and it's really nothing. But I think this took me an hour or so. So, yep, not the quickest thing to do. I was thinking we're going to try, not today, but we're going to try and make this thing functional as well. And I want to stick some hay bales in here just for decoration. but I want to make it functional, and I think it could be pretty interesting. Do we place one? I think that's cool, like so. and I want to stick... Didn't bring any glowstone, but I want to stick glowstone probably underneath these hay bales. Every here and there. I don't know if these need water. If you know, you can please let me know down below. That's looking good, though. That's pretty gorgeous. I like that. Just adds a little bit to the boringness of this thing. The reason we use wheat here, by the way, or the reason I want crops, because I'm going to mix it up with other crops, but the reason I use crops, if you didn't understand, was to get rid of the grass color. And I think it does a pretty good job at it, if I do say so myself. Of course, we come now with some trees and some other things, and we make it beautiful. The road, I wanted to bring you in for the road here. Would I be crazy if I would say that we don't go with a gravel road here? Possibly, most likely. But I wanted to try... How is it that I make that trodden dirt? Didn't I do exactly that? Hello. Okay, let's try it here then. That's kind of weird. Oh, okay, I need coarse dirt. Aha. Okay. Alright, where were we? Coarse dirt. Thank God for Medilock's base, eh? There we go. Trodden dirt. I may be completely crazy. This may not look good at all, but I wanted to at least give it a shot. This is, after all... Oh, wow, you walked really fast on this thing. Didn't account for that. Look at this, though. It looks really good. This is coming in 1.9, I've heard. Vanilla 1.9. Looks pretty good on its own. Like, it doesn't necessarily need to be mixed up. That looks kind of weird. I don't know. I like the lighting effects that it gets for sure. I really like the lighting effects that it gets. Maybe a thing that we try. Let's also do this now. I did bring some glowstone and I colored it green. And I don't know if that will be completely... No, that gives us a little bit of an effect in the wheat, I think. No, not at all. Okay, let's do this then. You ready? Break you. There we go. Did that not do anything? Ah, crap. Okay, I'll figure out a way to light this. The way I do this in vanilla is I build these guys, the scarecrows. These guys, the scarecrows I build. And they stand on some kind of light. Hello. But this is tedious. Look at this. Just doing one like this is... Yeah. Take some time. That's because we don't have any light. I bet you. I wanted to also give you a little bit of my peace of my mind for this thing over here. Let's put a torch down. I'm thinking the base structure of this thing being something like this. And then maybe we just go a little bit like this for that pillar. And maybe we leave the middle ones as they are. Can I? I have too much junk everywhere in the inventory. Yes, I think we could do that. You know what we could also do? Let's try out something here. Let's exchange you for some great wood logs. Boom. It's looking pretty good, I think. And get you and exchange you. And then maybe we do... Look at me. Now I'm getting creative. That may actually not be terrible, but maybe we want to bring it up like a zoo. Yeah, but you kind of get the feel. Spartanic, I think is the Swedish word, ground base, and then we can place down chests and barrels, and we can decorate with hay bales and, you know, that kind of stuff, so that it really looks like a farming steampunky house. And then we put the white and the great logs above this, so we would come with the great logs if we keep the same style. It would be something like this, right? I think that's gonna look pretty cool. Hay bales are kind of like leaves of any farm build. You add them and they will be gorgeous no matter what. It's a great block if you use it wisely. But I think this is exactly what I was looking for. I played around with this a little bit. Skipped the whole... We're going to mix this slightly, but not too much. It's definitely going to be cobble as the base block. But yeah... I think it looks good. And check out the floor. Check out the floor that I did. I just created a lot of these nooks, by the way, for now. So I lit the wheat field with using these. And you can see that it looks really, really freaking cool when it's lit. But yeah, this floor, man. This floor, ain't that a gorgeous thing? This trotted dirt, I'm going to use a lot in vanilla for putting in like this, because it gives that light effect and it looks really cool. I was curious to see if a glowstone block would work underneath somewhere there, but it doesn't seem to do a difference. I was thinking maybe they acted as slabs, but they may once they're in vanilla. But I think this is really the start of something, right? We have this house. That sounded super weird, I know. We make this house be kind of the storage for all the crops. And as I was saying earlier, I don't just want to have wheat. I'm growing the wheat first now because that's going to be majority. But then I'm going to mix in redstone crops. And there are so many things from AgriCraft that they have added now. They've added like all the different ores and a lot of different things they've added. So I want to grow a few different things here. I want to grow, someone said this earlier, a long time ago, that we should grow beef weed seeds. Maybe we do that. But I wanted to I want to hear what you guys say. Should we, this area over here, I'm thinking we make like yards of animals. That way we get away with the animal spawning a little bit because we are populating the lands with animals, as I was talking about in a previous episode. I'm going to remove this, by the way. We ain't doing this here. So we get rid of that, and it makes sense to have animals here, kind of, I think. Would also make sense to have a windmill here, but hey, that's over there, so it ain't gonna be here. But anyway, I think that's gonna be it for today's episode. I'm changing this for gravel, and we're sticking with the gravel slash stone slash cobble, regular road. And I had to cough there. We're sticking with the regular road, but I'm very excited about this little farmland. I was really, really upset when I saw that there was taiga, but hey, we fix things, right? That's what we do. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed today's Agrarian Skies episode. There will be a technical episode back in the spawn base here pretty soon. I want to make a what's it called? Bedrockium farm so badly. So we'll switch it up a little bit for those of you who are more into the technical stuff. But I'm really loving building here. We made a beautiful bridge. We made this place super gorgeous today. We started this. So thank you again. Hit the like button if you enjoyed. Do leave me some comments, and I see you in the next episode.